on the beat to protect their country. Fiji authorities continue the fight against the latest global enemy, COVID-19.
In a situation like we are in, we first of all would like to contain the damage. While research is going on for a medical counter.
Fiji confirmed its first case of COVID-19 last month and began locking down Lautoka and Suva, restricting travel and closing its borders. Schools are closed until June and non-essential businesses remain shut as people are told to stay home and observe an 8 p.m. to 5 a.m. nationwide curfew.
COVID-19 has really affected me and my family. Actually, I've been kept away from work for the past almost a month. My child hasn't been going to school. He's only in year three. We will not be able to visit our family. Our friends were not able to come home.
This COVID-19 has restricted us from social gatherings and get-togethers, such as funerals and just a bowl of grog.
Earlier this week, 18 people had tested positive for COVID-19 with no deaths so far. The government's extended its quarantine period from 14 to 28 days, introduced new health measures at hospitals, and enforced its ban on social gatherings. The opposition leader and former prime minister supports these efforts, but feels it's a little too late.
It is a necessity. These things have to be done. When we're in a situation such as this, people will have to be prepared to forego some of the rights and the enjoyments of normal times.
Meanwhile, officials continue the public screening campaign in Suva and Lautoka, which involves health assessments and temperature scans. However, not everyone is adhering to the new measures. Hundreds have been arrested for breaching restrictions.
Our Fijian lifestyle is more about social. So most of these arrests and most of these cases are basically on social gatherings, which has been highlighted by the government not to, we don't have to exercise this regularly because of this COVID-19 thing.
Fiji is one of seven countries in the Pacific with confirmed COVID-19 cases, and like their neighbours, tourism has taken a battering.
So many people, actually in thousands, who have lost their jobs because the country has shut its borders, no flights going in and out, and basically tourists from our traditional markets, Australia and New Zealand, have stopped coming.
Tourism employs about 150,000 people and makes up nearly 40% of Fiji's GDP. The government stepped in to assist businesses and workers during the crisis, offering a $1 billion Fijian economic stimulus in late March.
It's also a good lesson for us. If we are to survive similar impact in the future, then we must learn not to have all our eggs in one basket. We should be more reliant on a broader source of revenue to support our economy in the future.
Others just can't wait to return to normal, whatever that may be.
I think one of the biggest challenges is just making sure that the kids and all of us come out all right after weeks and months of just staying at home and looking at the same environment, which I think can get to children, especially teenagers.